has been on a fast for the last 8 days, demanding that governance be restored in the state of Goa, and that Goa desperately needs a full-time chief minister. On the 21st, outside the residence of the chief minister, we had given the chief minister a 48-hour ultimatum to resign as chief minister. And we had given it because we were officially informed by the deputy collector, who met us on behalf of the administration, that Manohar Parrikar is physically incapacitated and that he is not in a position to meet or speak to anyone. So in view of that, we had given Manohar Parrikar 48 hours to resign. Now the deadline came to an end last night, and Manohar Parrikar adamantly continues to cling to the chair. So now it's time for the citizens for restoration of good governance to hit the streets. Tomorrow evening, it will be launched with a public meeting right here tomorrow evening at 5 p.m. And the public meeting will be presided by Goa's well-known cardiologist, Dr. Francis Culasso. Manohar Parrikar, for the last 9 months, has been ailing very grievously, and the administration has come to a standstill while the Goa governor, who has a constitutional responsibility to have stepped in such a situation, she is silently watching, should read some books of history so that he knows what has happened in the past. Vinay Tendulkar, day before yesterday, said that Manohar Parrikar is not the first chief minister to be sick. Yes, we all know that. But every chief minister, when he was sick, he handed over charge of the chief minister's post to the senior most minister. More recently, we have seen Jayalalitha. When she was sick, she handed over the charge of chief ministership, the entire chief ministership, to the senior most minister. And now we will be announcing the future plan of action, because it is time to hit the streets, and at tomorrow's meeting at 5 o'clock, because this agitation to restore governance in the state of Goa will be spread over all the 12 talukas. So the agitation, which will be announced tomorrow, will be spread over all the 12 talukas, and we can assure the people of Goa that before the coming of 19th December, Goa will be once again liberated.
या आंदोलनात एक आंदोलक, एक निमंत्रक ह्या नात्यान हांव काही गजाली क्लियर करूंक सोदतां. काल बीजेपीचे गोवा प्रदेश अध्यक्ष आणि राज्यसभेचे खासदार आशिल्ले विनय तेंडुलकरांनी राजन घाटेच्या आंदोलनाच्या संदर्भात जे वक्तव्य केले ते अत्यंत निषेधार्य वक्तव्य असा, बेजबाबदारीचे वक्तव्य असा. त्या वक्तव्यातल्यान ताणें दाखोवन दिला की गोंयकारांनी कितलोय जरी आवाज केलो आणि कितलेय जरी बोवाळ केलो तरी आमी गोंयकारांक मानिना, जावं किंवा लोकांक मानिना, हे ताणें दाखोवन दिल्ले आसा. उपोशण हे सनशीर मार्गाचो शेवटचो पायरी आसा. आणि ज्यांना एखादो मनीस उपोषण करता त्यांना त्याच्या उपोषणाची नोंद घेऊकच जाय हे सरकारी गाईडलाईन असतानाय एका जबाबदार व्यक्तीन आम्ही उपोषणाक मानित ना हे सांगप म्हणल्यार गोयकारांचो सरळ सरळ इन्सल्ट आहा. ताका लागून सगळ्यांत पहिली आम्ही विनय तेंडुलकरांच्या त्या वक्तव्याचो पुरेपूर निषेध करता. तर सरकारान आमची वेळीच योग्य ती नोंद घेतली ना जर जायत जाल्यार अशेंच प्रत्येक तालुक्यांतल्यानूय उपोषणाक सुरवात जातली. सरकारान हाची ताबडतोब बेगोबेग नोंद घेवची. त्याच बरोबर आमची कितें डिमांड सरकार मुख्यमंत्र्यान राजिनामो दिवचो असोच कितें आमचो आमची मागणी ना. मुख्यमंत्र्यान जेन्ना आपूण केपेबल ना तेन्ना आपलो चार्ज दुसऱ्या कोणा कडेन तरी हँड ओवर करचो आनी गोंय सरकार वेवस्थीत सुरळीत चलोवपा खातीर तेणें हातभार लावचो इतलीच आमची मागणी आसा. जरी आपलो कारभार तेणें दुसऱ्याच्या हातीन सुवाती केलो जर जायत जाल्यार एकूण आमकां आमी आमचें आंदोलन हांगा थांबयतले.